I did a reconversation with a team, and we knew in the end it's very important to get fresh legs, because there are two hard climbs in the end. And of course you need to start strong, because when you lose 1 minute in the first 30 kilometers, yeah, you cannot close the gap on a good time trialist like that. But I heard at the last intermediate split I get, the third time, so I knew for sure I will be on the podium, because I saved some energy. And I also knew that Castroviejo would be too strong to beat, but only 30 seconds behind Castroviejo is very good for me. So yeah, I'm very happy with the result today.
What is a bit early, because the season is still going on, but how do you judge your season? It was your first one with Lotto and El Jumbo. It's pretty good. We saw on the last Vuelta that you're gaining strength.
Yeah, it's my first season in the World Tour. Before I was a professional cyclist in Topsport Vlaanderen. That's a smaller team, very good to develop as a pro cyclist. But now in the World Tour, I know what real racing is. I did Paris-Nice, Baskeland, and then Dauphiné and Vuelta. And there are real races when they go uphill full gas. You have to just struggle to stick with the peloton. And that makes me a lot stronger in the time trials, I think, when I see through the season. I think I need a few more years in this level to get a real good time trialer, to compete at the very highest level, to compete with riders as Castroviejo, Dumoulin, or Martin, riders like them. And I want to improve in my road cycling to get a better rider in the big hills to work for my, like, Steven Kruiswijk is one of my major teammates. Next year in the Giro d'Italia, we will try to win the Giro d'Italia, and they need some good workhorses for the big mountains.
For you, it's not only about time trial. You try also to improve your climbing. Maybe not why to become a leader in the GC next year.
No, maybe I can be a leader in the GC in races like Eneco Tour, Tour of Denmark, Tour of Belgium, races like that. But I know in big tours, Grand Tours, Vuelta, Le Tour, Giro, then you have to be a real climber. And I know I will never be a real climber, but I think I can be a real good helper in the mountains. And to get a real cycling career, you cannot only be a time trialist, and you need to improve to be a really good member of a team.
Just to conclude, you said you were in Topsport. It was a really good development team. We are here in European Championship, which was before only for under 23 and below categories. Why Topsport is it's a good development team?
I think it's a very good development team, because they work with only youth riders, so you are with a group that needs to develop. The main goal is development. You do a lot of small races in France, Coupe de France, races like that. The step is not too big from the under 23 riders to the professional category. I think it's better like that than immediately go to a World Tour team and do your last race under 23, a small kermis race, and then the next year do Paris-Nice. I think that's not a good solution. So I think Topsport Vlaanderen is a good step to develop.
The next goal, top 10 in the world?
I think that's a good goal.